Good morning and welcome. In previous class, we already do sums number 1 to 5 in chapter 25. The chapter 25 is height and distance. 1 to 5 are done in previous class and number 6 to 10 are homework. Now, in this class today, we will do from number 11. First, I read the sum number 11. From a point on the roof of five-storied building, at the five-storied building, the angle of elevation of the top of a monument and that of angle of depression of the foot of the monument are 60 degree and 30 degree respectively. Angle of elevation is 60 degree and angle of depression is 30 degree. If the height of the building is 16 meters, let us write by calculating the height of the monument and distance of the building from the monument. At first, we draw this figure. Sorry, number 11. Page number 326. First, we draw a five-storied building. This is now five-storied building. And this is the monument. Now this is the ground, horizontal line. This is the ground. AB with the height. AB with the height of the building. And A is the roof of the building. And CD is the height of the monument. We draw a line. Draw a horizontal line through A. Now this point be E. Now angle of elevation of the top of a monument. A is the top point. And now the angle of elevation. This is the angle of elevation. This is the angle of elevation. This angle is given. Angle of elevation is 60 degree. This is the angle of elevation, this angle is 60 degree. And angle of depression, and that angle of depression of the foot of the monument, D is the foot of the monument. Now, this is the angle of depression, which angle? This angle is angle of depression. This angle is 30 degree. Now, this angle are equal. Because AE and BD are parallel, AD is transversal, so these two angles are alternate angles, so therefore these angles is also equals to 30 degree. And height of the building is 16 meter. AB is the height of the building is 16 meter given. Now we calculate height of the monument and distance of the building from the monument. Let AB equal to 16 meter be the height of building. 16 be the height of CD be the height of monument. So in this figure, two right angles are formed. Right angle ABD. This is also right angle. And AEC. This is also right angle triangle. From right angle triangle ABD, from right angle triangle ABD, according to this angle 30 degree, AB is the height and BD is the base. AB by BD, AB is the height, when AB is the height means AB is perpendicular where BD is base, perpendicular by base, this is now 10, 30 degree. Now putting the value of AB, AB is 16 by BD, and value of 1030 is 1 by root 3, which implies BD equals to 16 root 3. BD equals to 16 root 3. So therefore, BD and AE are equal. So therefore, AE equals to 16 root 3. Also from also again from right angle triangle AEC, AEC, this is the right angle triangle. According to this angle, EC is the perpendicular, A is the base, EC divided by AE, EC divided by AE, EC is the perpendicular and A is the base, perpendicular by base is 10 60 degree, which implies EC, value of AE 16 root 3 equals to value of 1060 is root 3, which implies EC equals to 16 root 3 into root 3, root 3 into root 3 is 3, 16 into 3, this is equals to 48, EC equals to 48. Therefore, height of monument is, CD is the height of the monument, and CD has two parts, EC and ED, EC plus ED. Now EC is 48 and ED equals to AB. Now 48 plus value of AB is 16. So this is equal to 64 meter. Height of monument is 64 meter. And also one question. And distance of the building from the monument distance of building and monument is BD. So now BD is 16 root 3 meter. Okay, copy it. Sum number 12. I read the sum. I am flying a kite having the length of thread 250 meters when the thread makes an angle 60 degree with the horizontal line, and when the thread makes an angle 45 degree with the horizontal line. Let us write by calculating in each case what is the height of kite from me. Let us find in which of two cases will the kite be at a greater height from the other. The length of thread is 250 meter. An angle of thread with the horizontal line is 60 degree in first case, and in second case, the angle of thread with the horizontal line is 45 degree. Let us write by calculating in each case what is the height of the kite from me. That means, what is the height of the kite from the horizontal line? And let us find in which of the two cases will the kite be at a greater height from the other. नंबर 12. Now this is the horizontal line. This is the horizontal line. From this point, fly a kite. This angle is, this is the first case, 60 degree, and height of the kite is this. Height of the kite is this. Now again, the angle of thread with the horizontal line is 45 degree. This angle is 45 degree. In this case, this is the height of the kite. In first case, AB be the height of the kite, and in second case, CD be the height of the kite. And this is the point M. Let this is the point M. At this point, M means man. A man flying a kite. Length of thread AM. Length of thread AM. AM is 250 meter. And make an angle 60 degree with the horizontal. Again, the man flying a kite of height CD, and in this case the thread is CM is also 250 meter. Thread is constant. Let in first case AB be the height of the kite, and in second case, CD be the height of the kite. And M be the point. M be the point on horizontal line. Now two right angle triangles form. Triangle ABM and triangle CDM. From right angle triangle ABM. From right angle triangle ABM, AB divided by AM, AD divided by AM. Mohammad Rashid, please mute your mic. AB by AM, AB is perpendicular, AM is hypotenuse. In right angle triangle, perpendicular by hypotenuse. In right angle triangle, in what trigonometric ratio? Perpendicular by hypotenuse. Perpendicular by hypotenuse is sine 60 degree. Perpendicular by hypotenuse is sine theta. Now this is AB by AM is sine 60. Now this is equals to AB, which implies AB by AM, AM is 250 and sine 60 is root 3 by 2, which implies AB equals to 125 root 3. AB is 125 root 3. Again from right angle triangle, CDM divided by MC. According to this angle, this is the angle of 45 degree, CD is perpendicular and CM is hypotenuse. Perpendicular by hypotenuse is sine. Now this is sine 45 degree, which implies value of CD and value of MC is 250 and value of sine 45 1 by root 2. This is equals to CD equals to 250 into root 2 divided by root 2 into root 2. Root 2 into root 2 is 2. Now this is 125 root 2. In first case, the height of the kite is 125 root 3, and in second case, the height of the kite is 125 root 2. Now we write the answer. So therefore, in first case, height of the kite is 125 root 3 meter, and in second case height of the kite is 125 root 2 meter. Which one is greater? 125 root 3 and 125 root 2, which one is greater?
125 root 3.
125 root 3 is greater. Now, as 125 root 3 is greater 125 root 2, so therefore, in first case, is greater height from the other. Therefore, in first case, is greater height from the other. Is greater height is greater height. This is the answer. Okay, copy this. Number 13, a passenger of an aeroplane observes that Howrah station is at one side of the plane and Shahid Minar is just on the opposite side. The angle of depression of Howrah station and Shahid Minar from the passenger of aeroplane are 60 degree and 30 degree respectively. If the aeroplane is at height of 545 root 3 meter at that time, let us find the distance between Howrah station and Shahid Minar. Again, I read the sum. A passenger of 13. At first, we draw a horizontal line. This is the horizontal line, and this is the height of the aeroplane. AB be the height of the aeroplane, and in one side of AB is Howrah station. Now this is the Howrah station H, and another side of aeroplane is Shahid Minar. So this is now Shahid Minar, S. A is the aeroplane. From aeroplane, the angle of depression of Howrah station is 60 degree. Now angle of depression of Howrah station, 60 degree. Now angle of depression This is the angle of depression. Therefore, this angle is 60 degree. And angle of depression of Shohid Minar is 30 degree. This is the angle of depression of Shohid Minar. This angle is 30 degree. So these and these are alternate angles. So therefore, this angle is 30 degree. And AB is the height of the aeroplane. And AB is given, AB equals to 545 root 3 meter. AB is 545 root 3 meter. Now distance between Howrah station and Shohid Minar. Let AB be the height of aeroplane. The point H, the points H and S be the Howrah station. Howrah station and Shohid Minar. Shohid Minar respectively. So therefore AB equals to 545 root 3 meter. So therefore two right angles from right angle triangle ABH from right angle triangle ABH. B is right angle. AB by HB. AB by HB. According to angle 60 degree, AB is the perpendicular HB as base. Perpendicular by base is tan 60. So therefore AB is given 545 root 3. 545 divided by HB and value of tan 60 is root 3. Now root 3 cancel in both sides, which implies HB equals to 545. HB is 545. Again from right angle triangle ABS. Again from right angle triangle ABS, AB by BS. According to angle 30 degree, AB is perpendicular and BS is base. Perpendicular by base is tan 30 degree, which implies AB is 545 root 3 divided by base is BS is equals to 1 by root 3, which implies BS equals to 545 root 3 into root 3. So now this is equal to 545 into 3 meter. This is the BS. So therefore, distance from Howrah station to Shohid Minar, distance of Howrah station to Shohid Minar is, the distance is HS, and HS equal to write HB plus BS. HB plus BS, HB is 545 plus BS is 545 into 3 meter. Now this is equals to 545 into 4 meter. Now 545 into 4, 500 into 4, this is 2000, and 45 into 4, 45 to the 90, 90 to the 180, so this is 2180 meter. So this is 2180 meter. This is the answer. The distance of Shahid Minar, Howrah Station to Shahid Minar is 2180 meter or 2.18 kilometer. Okay, copy this. Okay, thank you. The question number 14, 15, 16 are homework. Next Thursday, I will take another class. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.